Welcome to Foam University. Today we're going to talk about if having too much insulation in your attic can be a bad thing. Simply put, yeah, it can. So let's say, for example, you have cellulose or fiberglass on the floor of your attic. Okay, well, if you add layer upon layer to that, there can be a couple problems. First, let's talk about cost. Obviously, each layer of cellulose you put on there is going to add cost. Okay, so there can be a certain point where you could be spending upwards to, you know, $15,000 or more in cellulose insulation. Let's say you have 2 feet or more of cellulose. Now, is that 2 foot pile of cellulose worth how much money you've accumulated in cost? Maybe, maybe not. But keep in mind that cost over time will continue to go up in order to keep its effectiveness up as well. So something else to talk about is health concerns. Now there's a couple main things in there. One, moisture. Fibrous insulation is prone to retain moisture. So if you add a layer on top of insulation that already has moisture in it, now you're trapping that moisture inside your living space. Not a good thing. Now again, if you add a layer on top of that, maybe some more moisture gets mixed in. We all know that moisture problems can easily grow into bigger issues. Now this leads me into my next thing on health. If you have any pest issues that may have burrowed or nested inside that fibrous insulation, maybe they left some droppings behind, maybe some other things in there, who knows? Now, could that be a health concern? Definitely. Is it for sure? No one really knows. But again, you add layer upon layer to that, you're really just keeping all that inside your house. So keep that in mind. Now let's jump over to spray foam. Can too much of a good thing be bad? In this case, I'm gonna say yeah. So if you have 20 inches of spray foam up in your attic, I'm gonna say you're probably wasting money. With spray foam, just like anything else, at a certain point, its value does get diminished. So again, like anything else, there's a sweet spot with spray foam. If you go past that, like I said, you're just gonna be wasting money. So you're going to really wanna make sure you and your contractor are on the same page and make sure that you and your project is getting exactly what it needs. And keep in mind down the road, if those costs do increase, like I said, by adding layers and layers, you know, maybe that's not the right way to go because your value could go out the window. You know, it's one thing to keep in mind with spray foam versus something like fiberglass or cellulose. Hope this information was helpful to you guys. If you have questions about, you know, you're looking to insulate your attic or re-insulate it, but you're not sure which route to go, you know, maybe you're looking at putting in 20 inches of insulation, please talk to us. We want to help you out. But please like this video, subscribe to our channel, and don't forget to smash that bell so you see all of our notifications. And that's how the foam's applied. Oh, excuse me. Professor of Foam here. How can I warm you up?